Early one morning, Peter opened the gate that surrounded his house and went out into the big green meadow. Of a large tree sat a little bird, Peter's friend. "Everything is quiet," chirped the bird happily. A duck appeared, waddling from side to side. She was glad that Peter had not closed the gate because now she could take a nice swim in the deep pond in the meadow. The little bird flew down upon the grass, settled next to the duck, and shrugged his shoulders. "What kind of bird are you if you can't fly?" he asked, to which the duck replied, "What kind of bird are you if you can't swim?" And she dived into the pond. Argued, the duck swimming in the pond, the little bird hopping along the shore. Suddenly, something caught Peter's attention. He noticed a cat crawling through the grass.
Hmm.
cat thought, that little bird is busy arguing. I'll just grab it. Slowly she crept toward the bird on her velvet paws. Look out, shouted Peter, and the bird immediately flew up into the tree. The duck was quacking angrily at the cat. From the middle of the pond. The cat walked around the tree and thought, is it worth climbing up that high? By the time I get there, the bird will surely have flown away. Just then, Grandfather came out. He was angry because Peter had gone past the gate into the meadow. It is a dangerous place. If a wolf should come out of the forest, then what would you do? Grandfather's warning, because boys like him are not afraid of wolves. Grandfather took Peter by the hand and led him home and locked the gate. The cat quickly climbed up the tree. The duck quacked and in her excitement jumped out of the pond. But no matter how fast the duck tried to run, the wolf ran faster. He was getting nearer and nearer, catching up to the duck. And then he caught her and with one gulp swallowed her. This is how things stood. The cat was sitting on one branch. The little bird on another. Not too close to the cat. Down below, the wolf walked round and round the tree, looking at them with greedy eyes. Peter, without the slightest fear, stood behind the lock gate, watching all that was going on. All of a sudden, Peter had a great idea. So he ran home, got a strong rope, and climbed up the high stone wall that surrounded his house. One of the branches of the tree around which the wolf was walking stretched out over the wall. Grabbing hold of the branch, Peter quickly climbed over onto the tree. Said to the little bird, "Fly down and circle around the wolf's head. Only be careful that he doesn't catch you." You know, that little bird almost touched the wolf's head with his wings, while the wolf snapped angrily at him from all directions.
Oh,
the little bird did bother the wolf, how the wolf wanted to catch him. But the little bird was clever, and the wolf simply couldn't do anything about it. Meanwhile, Peter made a lasso with the rope, and carefully letting it down, he slipped the lasso over the wolf's tail and pulled with all his might. Feeling himself caught, the wolf began to jump wildly, trying to get loose. Following the wolf's trail and shooting as they went. Said, "Don't shoot. The little bird and I have already caught the wolf. All you have to do is help us take it to the zoo." In the lead. possession were Grandfather and the cat. Grandfather shook his head grumpily and said, "Well, what if Peter hadn't caught the wolf? What then?" Inside the wolf's stomach, because the wolf had been in such a hurry that he had swallowed her alive.